A very good morning, students, and welcome back again to the statistics class. So in the previous class, I was explaining about the factor reversal test. Now, what is this factor reversal test? It is nothing but where you are reversing the factor. Now, when I say factor, it is nothing but the price and the quantity. Okay. So these are the factors. When you say time, it is the base and the current year, that is time. And when they say factor, it is the price and the quantity. Okay. So you have to reverse the price and the quantity, that is the factor. Okay. You have to reverse price as quantity and quantity as price. Your time will not be reversed. Only the factor P and Q will be reversed. So when you reverse the factor, it will consider both the price index as well as the quantity index. Why? It will consider when you reverse price into quantity, it will give you, see now, P01, when you reverse P, it becomes Q. So that means you are considering the both price index and quantity index. So if you see P into Q, it will give you nothing but the value of that particular item. Okay. And this method will satisfy only Fisher's. Other than Fisher's, no other method will be satisfied. In the time reversal test, Marshall-Edward also will be satisfied along with the Fisher index number. But when it comes to the factor reversal test, only one method, that is one index number, Fisher's index number, will be satisfied. So we say Fisher index is an ideal index number. You know that I was explaining you, and it is very important for 2 marks. Okay. We say Fisher index is an ideal index number. Why? Because it is a geometric mean, and also it will satisfy both the tests. One of the reason is why it is ideal index number, because it will satisfy both the tests, that is TRT and FRT. Okay. So we will work out one problem. Okay, I've explained you how we have to solve or test or see how it satisfies FRT. Okay, we'll work out one problem where you are very much clear and specific about how to solve the problem. Okay, and how it is different from time reversal test. Show that Lasprey's, Pasteur's, Marshall-Edward, Darbish, Bowley's index does not satisfy FRT. That means you have to show that this does not satisfy. Also, you have to show that Fisher index satisfy FRT. Okay. So this is the question, and see the items here, items and the information that has been given. Items are given A, B, C, D. Base year price is given. See, it is like this. Okay. Not like this. You have to be very careful. Base year price is given 2465. Current year price. Now, base year price of the base year is nothing but P0. Okay. Current year price is given, that is P1. Base year expenditure. Now, when you say expenditure, it is nothing but the total value of that particular item is given. Okay. So what you have to find? You have to find the, now base year expenditure is nothing but, it is both. You can say it as P0, Q0. Okay, when you multiply base and quantity of the price and the quantity of the base year, it will give you expenditure. So this value, whatever it is given, it is nothing but the base year expenditure. And also they have given us current year expenditure, that is nothing but P1, Q1. So what you have to find? You have to find Q0 and Q1. So how will you find? So you know, price into quantity is equal to expenditure, whereas you have to find quantity, so expenditure divided by price. Okay, so this is a formula. So now you know, I have written your table. Base year price is given, that is P0, 2, 4, 6, and 5. Okay, next, current year price is also given, that I have written here P1. P1, current year price, 5, 3, 10, and 7. Now let us calculate base year quantity, that is Q0. How will you calculate? That is expenditure. What is the expenditure? When you say base year anta heluvaga, new adaradde consider maadbeku. Base year anta heluvaga, base year expenditure consider maadbeku. Current year agudilla. Base year ge base consider maadbeku. Current year ge current expenditure consider maadbeku. So iga base year idda anta heluvaga. Expenditure. What is the expenditure of the base year? 20. Okay, first product A. What is the expenditure? 20. So 20 divided by, what is the price of that base year? 2. 20 divided by 2, that is 10. So quantity is 10. Understood? So I will simply, you know, now expenditure anta helvaga, you write it as E0. Expenditure E of the base year 0. So current year expenditure is nothing but E1. So simply I'll write a formula here so that you can understand what you have to do. Expenditure divided by price. So expenditure of the base year divided by the price of the base year. Simple. Okay. Next. Second, for B, 24 divided by 4. 24 divided by 4. How much? It will give you 6. Okay. Next, 30 divided by 6. 30 divided by 6, it is 5. And last one is 55 divided by 5, it is 11. Okay. It is same students, no difference. You have to understand the problem very clearly. Okay. Don't simply consider expenditure and tadu quantity and convert maadi sumne mistake maadbedi. Okay, expenditure koduvaga new quantity and find out maadbeku. Next, second thing is what you have to calculate current year expenditure kottidare E1. Okay, so what you have to consider? You have to consider current year price and current year expenditure. That is 50 divided by 5, that is 10. 21 divided by 3, that is 7. 80 divided by 10 is 8. And 21 divided by 7 is 3. Okay. Now you have all the information. You got quantity of the current year after E1 divided by P1. That is expenditure of the current year divided by the price of the current year. Okay. Once you find this, after that, you have to find all the four information. What are the four information? That will not change in any of the problem. That is P1 Q0, P0 Q0, P1 Q1, P0 Q1. These are the four informations that you have to calculate. Okay. That will not change. That will remain same. Okay. Okay. Start calculating. Let's calculate the values of all these. Information that is required. So I have already calculated and given you the value here. So once again, I will tell you how to calculate. You have to calculate all the four informations. Okay. That is P1, Q0, P0, Q0, P1, Q1, P0, Q1. Okay. So you know P1, Q0 means P1 into Q0. P0, Q0 is P0 into Q0. P1, Q1 is P1 into Q1. P0, Q1 is P0 into Q1. You just multiply and find the total of it. Now let us go back to the question. What is asked? They have said this is not time reversal test, students. This is factor reversal test. The first method, you hope you understood. The creating of the table is same from the very first problem. Okay. Very first problem. Nano last time in the in maadiddene first price index. Allinda illi varege yavudakku change agudilla. Quantity bandru kuda yenagutte change agudilla. Ee table anna same agi consider maadbeku. ಯಾವಾಗ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆಂಡಿಚರ್ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ ನೀವು ನೋಡ್ಬೇಕು ಅವರು ಪ್ರೈಸ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರಾ ಅಥವಾ ಕ್ವಾಂಟಿಟಿಯನ್ನು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಯಾವ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಯಾವ್ದು ಕೊಡ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ ಅದು ನೀವು ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ ಒನ್ಸ್ ಯು ಫಿನಿಶ್ ದಟ್ ನೌ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಗೋ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಟು ದ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಶೋ ದಟ್ ಓಕೆ ದಟ್ ಲಾಸ್ಪ್ರೇ ಪಾಸ್ಚೆ ಮಾರ್ಷಲ್ ಎಡ್ವರ್ಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆರ್ಬಿಶ್ ಬೌಲೀಸ್ ಇಂಡೆಕ್ಸ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸ್ಯಾಟಿಸ್ಫೈ ಎಫ್ ಆರ್ ಟಿ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸ್ಯಾಟಿಸ್ಫೈ FRT. Okay. And also you have to show that Fisher index satisfies FRT. So first we will move to the first one. Okay. First we will move to the first one, that is Lasprey's index. Now, according to FRT, you know, price of the base and current year. When you reverse the factor, it becomes quantity that should give you the value of that particular item. Now, when I say value, it is nothing but summation P1 Q1 divided by summation P0 Q0. Now, if you see here, okay, P1 Q1, what is the value? 172 divided by P0 Q0. P0 Q0 is 129. That is, you should get this answer at the end, okay, when you find. Now, when it comes to the Lasbury, what is the formula? Summation P1 Q0 divided by summation P0 Q0. Okay, I'll write here. This is price index into, now you have to write the reverse of that, that is the quantity. Now, when you write the quantity, it becomes Q1 P0 divided by summation Q0 P0. Okay, okay, it should give you the answer as value. Now, if you see here, okay, if you see here, first I will write the values of it. P1 Q0, it is 195 divided by 129 into Q1 P0, Q1 P0, this one. 1 into 5 is also 5, 5 into 1 is also 5. So P0 Q1 or Q1 P0 is one and the same. Okay, so what is the value? 111 divided by 172. What I said, your answer should be this one, 172 by, if you see here, is it equal? No, it is not equal to. So it is not equal to value index. Number. Okay, so it is not equal to value index number. You have to write only so much. Okay, second one is past J. Past J is index. Now, when you say past J is index, what is the formula? See, the condition is P01 into Q01, that is equal to B01. Okay, so summation P1, you got past J is index on the Hirvaga, P1 Q1, quantity of the current year agate, divided by summation P0 Q1 into, reverse the factor, that is summation Q1 P1 divided by summation Q0 P1. If you see here, what is the value? P1 Q1, 129 divided by 111 into Q1 P1 172 divided by Q0 P1. So Q0 P1 is here, it is 195. So again, if you see here, okay, it will not satisfy. You have to get this value, which value? This one. What I said, 172 by 129 as value, but you are not getting that value. So that means it is, it does not satisfy value. That is, it is does not satisfy FR. FRT. You have to write here the conclusion that Lasbury's index does not satisfy FRT. Okay, here also you have to write past J's index does not satisfy FRT. Okay, next. Marshall Edworth. Now, what is the formula? Okay, according to FRT, you know P01 into Q01 is equal to, it should give you the value. Okay, so okay, you have to write the formula of Marshall Edworth under price index number. So P01 under Marshall Edworth, what is the formula? Summation P1 Q0 plus summation P1 Q1 divided by summation P0 Q0 plus summation P0 Q1. Okay, so also you have to write the formula under quantity Q01, reverse the factor, that is Marshall Edworth, that is summation Q1 P0 divided by summation Q0 P0 plus summation Q1 P1 plus summation Q0 P1. Okay, this is the formula. So I'll write according to the condition, that is summation P1 Q0 plus summation P1 Q1 divided by summation P0Q0 plus summation P0Q1 into right the quantity formula, that is summation Q1 P0 plus summation Q1 P1 divided by summation Q0 P0 plus summation Q0 P1. Okay, it should give you the answer as value. Now let us substitute the value. P1 Q0, what is the value of P1 Q0? 195 divide plus P1 Q1 is 172 divided by P0 Q0, the value is 129 and 111 into Q1 P0. What is the value of Q1 P0? 111 plus P1 Q1 is Q, sorry, not P1 Q1, Q1 P1 is 172 divided by Q0 P0 is 129 plus 195. Okay. Now you have to add it. Add this. You cannot directly see that. 195 plus 172. It will give you 367. Plus divided by 129 plus 111 will give you 240. Okay. Into 111 plus 172 will give you 283 divided by 129 plus 195 will give you 324. Okay. Now if you see here, that it will not satisfy the value index. It will not satisfy value index. So don't have to further much calculate. It is already proved, students, that it will not satisfy. You have to only show, you have to only show that it is not satisfying. Okay. Yes. Next one, Darbish Bowley's. Okay. What is the formula now? That is half of summation P1Q0 divided by summation P0Q0 plus summation P1Q1 divided by summation P0Q1. This is P01 under Darbish Bowley. Next, you have to write about the quantity also, that is of Darbish Bowley. So half of, what is the formula? Summation Q1P0 divided by summation Q0P0 plus summation Q1P1 divided by summation Q0P1. Okay. So according to FRT, how you have to write? P01 into Q01, that is should be the value of the base and the current year. So I'll write the formula once again correctly. Half of summation P1Q0 divided by summation P0Q0 plus summation P1Q1 divided by summation P0Q1 into half of, write this one, summation Q1P0 divided by Q0P0 plus summation Q1P1 divided by summation Q0P1. Okay, now let us substitute the value. So half of P1Q0 is 195 divided by 129 plus P1Q1 is 172 divided by 111. 172 divided by 111 into half of Q1P0 is 111 divided by Q0P0 is 129 plus P1Q1 is 172 divided by 129. Sorry. Okay, so if you see this one also, okay, see here, 195 divided by 129, 172 divided by, okay, if you substitute also, what happens? You will not get the same answer. Okay, you don't have to further calculate it. So you can directly write. Okay, you can directly write it is does not satisfy value index number. Okay, it does not satisfy value index number. Okay, how it, what is the value of the value index number? It is, I've written here, you 172 divided by 129. You might think here in the numerator we have 172 common, in the denominator you have 129 common. But second thing you have to keep in mind, why it is not satisfying here, because ಒಂದು ಅದು ಅರಿಥ್ಮೆಟಿಕ್ ಮೀನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇದೆ. ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಒನ್ ಏನಂದ್ರೆ ಅದು ಇದು ಇಂಟು ಹಾಫ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕಿದೆ. ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅರಿಥ್ಮೆಟಿಕ್ ಮೀನ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ, ಯು ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸ್ಯಾಟಿಸ್ಫೈ ದ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಇಂಡೆಕ್ಸ್ ನಂಬರ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಫಿಶರ್ಸ್. ಫಿಶರ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೆಡ್, ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಪ್ರೂವ್ ದಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಸ್ಯಾಟಿಸ್ಫೈಸ್ ಎಫ್ ಆರ್ ಟಿ. ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಸೇ ಫಿಶರ್ಸ್ ಇಂಡೆಕ್ಸ್ ನಂಬರ್, ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಇಸ್, ಓಕೆ, what is the formula? According to FRT, P01, okay, into Q01, that should give you the value. Now when I say value, I'll write here summation Q1 P1 divided by summation P0 Q0. Okay, this one you should get. The answer, whatever you get final, should be this one. Okay, now according to FRT, okay, what is the formula for price index under Fisher? So P01 under Fisher, that is root of summation P1 Q0 divided by summation P0 Q0 into summation P1 Q1 divided summation P0 Q1. Okay, into what is the quantity? Okay, I'll write here itself, quantity of the Fisher, that is equal to summation Q1 P0 divided by summation Q0 P0 into summation Q1 P1 divided by summation Q0 P1. This is the formula. Now we will write according to the value. I'll write according to this now properly. That is root of summation P1 Q0 divided by summation P0 Q0 into summation P1 Q1 divided by summation P0 Q1. Okay, one second students. Into root of summation summation Q1 P0 divided by summation Q0 P0 into summation Q1 P1 divided by summation Q0 P1. Okay, that should give you the answer as summation P1 Q1 divided by summation P0 Q0. Okay, now let us substitute the value. I'll see here only and write 195 divided by 129 into 172 divided by 111. Okay, root into Q1 P0. See here, Q1 P0 111 divided by Q0 P0 is 129 into Q1 P1 is 172 divided by 195. Okay, now as it is in the geometric mean, you can, okay, you can easily do it. Okay, which is common here? You have 172 and 172. So bring it out, 172. Okay, it is square divided by 129, and 129 is there. So 129, you have also the root and take the, as it is twice, it is square. So cancel the root and the square. What is remaining? 172 by 129. So what is the value I said here? First, in the beginning, value 172 by 129. That means it satisfies FRT. Fisher index, 172 is equal to 129. That is nothing but summation P1 Q1 divided by summation P0 Q0. That is the value that you get. Okay, so I hope you all are clear with this. Still, if you all are not clear, you can ask me, students. In the previous also, when I did time reversal test also, I hope you all are clear because nobody has asked me doubts. If you have doubts, feel free to ask me. Do not keep within yourself. Clarify your doubts there and then. Okay, that is what I want to tell you. Okay, when it comes to the Fisher also, it is very easy. It is actually very easy, only that maybe when you write the formulas, you might get confused, but you have to write and practice very much. Only when you work out the problems, n number of problems, then only you will understand. Okay, keep in mind when it comes to time reversal test, two methods, that is Marshall-Edward and Fisher's will satisfy. In the FRT, only Fisher's will satisfy. And they will not ask you all the methods. They will ask you only Marshall-Edward and Fisher's of the both the methods to be calculated. So basically, most of the question paper they have asked you, okay, saying that show that Fisher index satisfies both TRT and FRT. I will do one that problem also in the next class so that it is very clear with you. Okay, so tomorrow I will finish with these concepts. One more problem I will do of only Fisher's where you have to satisfy both TRT and FRT. And there is one smaller concept, that is circular test. Again, there is no problem in that. It is only a small theory part, okay, that I'll explain you in within 5 minutes. Along with that, one problem where, okay, they will ask you both, or else I'll do Marshall-Edward and Fisher's of TRT and FRT, so that it is very clear. Okay, students, please watch the videos and not try to understand the concept. Okay, because you have to, if you do not understand, you can please contact me and ask me for the doubts anytime. Okay, and please start studying for your exam. I want you all to score well in your test. And whatever assignments that you are writing, please, the test you are writing, please make sure you keep it. And I want those copies to me when the college reopens, or we may ask you to post it to us. Okay, so please keep that copy. Simply, you may think we can take the scan of somebody else and we can take the print. No, we want your handwritten copy. Okay, so make sure you study and write your exam well. Thank you, students.